I'm Megan Mostyn Brown. I'm one of the playwrights for the Hotel Project New York. And so far I'm having a great time. I'm a playwright who I've been writing plays for the last 8 years, I guess. I normally write regular straight plays. I like to write plays about messed up people. This play for the Hotel Project is no different. Well, I was interested in doing it. I've never done theater for one. I liked the idea of what goes on in hotel rooms. It feels like secretive and a little seedy and like mysterious. Well, it's always great to work on something where there's a lot of other people involved, because as a writer you spend a lot of time by yourself. So it's cool to be a part of something where you get to meet a lot of people that you haven't met before. And also I'm excited to see what the other two writers have written. Like, I know my impressions of what I saw when I saw all three rooms, so it'll be fascinating to see what they have decided to come up with. I've been to site-specific stuff, but the theater, for one thing, as an audience member, makes me really uncomfortable. It feels very, it's like when they ask you to do like participation in theater, it feels too close. And I personally get really uncomfortable. So therefore I wrote a play that was super uncomfortable. that'll be interesting also to participate in their plays, because I personally don't enjoy being the only person in the room. Well, you always get a little worried, especially if you're just like being paired up with a director that you don't know. You get like worried that they're not going to have the same aesthetic, or like the same, you know, they don't want to work the same way that you do. And like, that didn't happen. I got a director who's awesome.
Okay.
So I get nervous about like work pairings. And you know, you don't want your play to suck, so you're always nervous that like whatever you wrote is people aren't gonna like. Well, initially my inspiration was the fact that you could see into apartments outside of the room. So that's sort of where I based the play on. And then as I started writing it, the play I ended up writing so far is really physical. Mm-hmm. There's like a lot of physical violence that happens. And I thought about and you're locked into the room, mm-hmm, by someone. So I definitely thought about being that audience member and having to move about the room to avoid whatever is going on, but also not being able to leave if you want to. If I was the audience, I'd hate it, but I was like, that as a writer, that's really interesting to me. So,
yeah.
So just like the space, plus the room is really tiny, so just spatially,
yes,
it was interesting to think about like, as an audience member, trying not to be in everyone's way, but like kind of always being in the way, even if, no matter where you are. No, because ultimately it's also like the dialogue in the situation doesn't stray that far from the regular style of, mm-hmm, stuff. It just has to do with like thinking spatially. And actually, for the last year I've been writing a screenplay for people on the West Coast, and so it was not dissimilar to thinking about how you would think about a scene in a movie, I guess, because it's more visual because you have the whole space to use as opposed to a stage.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I don't know if that makes sense, but
yeah.
So it didn't feel like a huge shift or challenge in my head. I mean, I don't know, we'll see when we get into the room. It's like, oh, that doesn't work at all. Then it will prove to be more challenging. The name of my play is called Your Broken Heart is Fucking Boring.